Good afternoon, automotive fanatics. It's Peter, your automotive fanatic, coming at you guys with another product unveiling, installation, and review. We are taking a look at a company called EVBASE and specifically examining their new 7-inch HVAC control system / multimedia control. So here we have the box from EVBASE, and taking a look at it, this is a well-packaged setup. We're gonna go ahead and open this up here and take a look at what is inside. Now, this system, just to give you a high-level overview, it is designed to help your rear passengers control their temperatures. In addition to that, because the system is Android-based, it is also going to be able to use as a multimedia system. Now, in my review, I will show you guys the things that you can do with this setup. And I already can see it. You folks that have young kids in the back, I think this is going to be an excellent product for you. So let's kind of continue in terms of what we have here. Again, the package is well cushioned and everything, so you don't have to worry about any type of damages. You've got some books here. It's broken into your wiring harness. And then this here is going to be your main 7-inch display. Now, they designed this as a complete replacement for your rear's center HVAC vents. So what we'll go ahead and do is we'll just briefly show you guys kind of how it is here. This is the HVAC, or where you're gonna get the airflow from. Here's the screen. Airflow is gonna come out of here to supply your rear passengers. So without further ado, I'm just gonna jump right into this and show you guys how excited I am to get this in. The first part of the installation is to remove the lower trim panel. Simply put your prying tool in and pry open the lower trim. The next part will be to remove the top vent. Simply grab it, pry it apart, and pull it from the center console. Disconnect the power cable that feeds the USB ports. Disconnect the CAN bus connection here. And from there, you're going to grab the cables that came with the EVBASE unit. Make sure you have the right one and go ahead and connect both of those together. The other end of the connection is simply gonna go ahead and plug right into the CAN bus connection right there. Make sure you hear an audible click and you know it's fully seated. Now we're going to go ahead and take the smaller cable and route it through the vent on up to the very top of the vent. Now that you have the cable routed, we're going to go ahead and take the EVBASE device. We're going to connect the power together just like that, and again, make sure it clicks. While we are at it, we are also going to take the USB power cable and connect it to the device as well. With the EVBASE device fully connected, we're going to go ahead and make sure that it works. With the device fully checking out to work perfectly, we're going to go ahead and tape some of the wires and get everything neatly tucked and put back onto the center console. Everything should snap together really easy, and just make sure it's nice and snug.
The final part of installation is tucking that CAN bus cable and putting back your trim. Give yourself a pat on the back. You just successfully installed the screen.
The first part here, I wanted to cover the home screen that is going to essentially mirror what the vehicle is doing. Here you have the main home screen. As you can see, there's a lot of push buttons that you can push. You've got your volume here. These are going to be your media controls that you can move it forward, backwards, and even pause it. Down here, you're going to have little icons that let you know that the seatbelt is unlatched. You've got your fan controller. Here, if you push the heated seat, here you have the rear heated seat section, and you simply select however you want it in terms of heating. And then if you simply close all, that can turn it off. But again, you can control the different levels. You guys see it's going through different levels. You're going to close all to kind of get rid of the heated seats. Now there is a back area, a back icon here. You're simply going to hit it just like that. And what it does is it brings you back once again to your home page. This here is going to be a diagram of essentially this, what you see. You've got your power button for your fan. Now here is the catch. If you click on it, you see that it's blue. You do see air is coming out on the screen. However, the vents here, there is no air coming out. The trick is you have to have the climate on the vehicle. So I'm going to go ahead and turn that on real quick. Okay, so the car's climate is on. I can feel the air coming out. I can go ahead and adjust the level of the fan. You can see that the graphics is showing that there's a lot of fan or air coming out. And you simply just toggle that bar on top here to control it. You have AC where you can hit it and it will turn on the AC. Same thing. Now, if you want to turn the fan off, you simply hit that icon. And now the car's front passenger remains on. However, there is no air coming out. This here controls your temperature. And it's currently listed in Celsius. Unfortunately, you cannot, as of this time, you cannot change it to Fahrenheit. EVBASE is making a software or firmware upgrade to it so that you can change it to Fahrenheit. You're going to have these three icons here. I'm not for sure what the ambient lighting is or this purification thing here is, but you can lock your temperature, which is cool. Over here, it lists the ambient temperature outside, once again in Celsius. You have your green battery meter. Now, if you hit the battery, you're going to get this little display here that shows that the car has essentially 87% electric power left. Now, to get back to the home screen, you hit this back arrow. And that brings you back to the home screen. Now, the home button here that you push will bring you back to this page if you're actually in the Android setup, and I'll go over that shortly. But this here, it's very basic. It does what you need it to do in terms of your seat control, your fan control. And again, you've got little displays that will let you know if the seatbelt is unlatched or if it's latched. So pretty nice. Just to go over a couple of other icons, you have your Wi-Fi, you have your Bluetooth. This is essentially going to be your location. And this here, if you have used an Android system before, if you hit it, it's going to show you the different applications that you have open. So again, to get back to the home screen, you're just going to simply hit home and you're back to the screen. I'm briefly going to show you how to get into the Android system. This clover leaf here, you're simply going to click on it, and now this is your Android setup. Those of you that have used Android before, you'll feel very at home. For you iPhone users, this is not complicated at all. You have your different applications. You've got YouTube, you've got your Play Store, you have Chrome, your videos that you can play from, your settings and such. So it's very intuitive use. Again, to get back to the other page that you were on, you just simply hit that back arrow and it brings you back here. Now I'm going to show you how to play music or sound from the back screen onto your main vehicle. So what you need to do is you need to connect phone. You're going to click on this button here. You're going to see a few different Bluetooths. The one that is set up, you want to make sure you choose the BFD-879B. Yours may be a little different, but just make sure it's something very similar to that. You're going to click on it here. Just connect. Let it do its thing. Now, rear display will play music through the Tesla system. I am going to show you the main benefits of having this system. Now, I think this setup here is going to be excellent for, let's say, parents that have young children who want to watch some videos on the back screen here. So what I went ahead and did was I went right into the Android system. I put in a flash drive. The car is connected to the dash setup here, so that the music will be able to play. Now what you're going to do is you're going to click on video here, and that is going to show you kind of the storage options. I'm going to choose my USB. I have music videos, and let's just play something real quick here. And I'm sorry guys, for this next part I'll play the video, but I'm going to cut the sound off because these are all licensed music here and I don't want to get some type of infringement. I went ahead and paused the video, but you guys saw the quality of the video. This is not a 4K display, so don't expect any type of 4K resolution, but this more or less is going to be a high level HD, which for this screen and what you're using it for, it's perfectly fine. There's no issues at all. So now that you guys know how video plays, I'm going to go back. I'm going to actually choose the the video that EVBASE provided so that you can see. And I'll let you kind of listen to the sound as well. And with this video, it looks fantastic. The camera does not do this justice at all, but as a passenger, I think it is very acceptable. The lobster here, very nice and vibrant. So I have no complaints on how this display here looks. So very nice here. We're going to just simply go back. I'll show you how to use the YouTube app. Very simple. Here it is. I am at home, so I was able to connect to my home network. And let's make sure It is on. We're going to make sure that I'm connected to my home network real quick. Okay, so I am connected. We'll go to YouTube. Let it go ahead and boot up. It does take a little bit of time to boot up that YouTube. And here is all of the stuff. Let's go ahead and search for my channel. I can play these because I know there's no copyright infringements. I can maximize it. Okay, there's maximizing it. And we'll just let it play. So again, the quality of the YouTube looks excellent. Here is the beauty of this here. You can actually get back to the home page while watching this. So what we're going to do, I'm going to minimize this to a certain point. We'll go back to my channel. We'll let it play. Here's that home icon. I'm going to click it. And check this out, guys. Here is the home display for the Tesla. However, you still have picture in picture. And this one, you can actually make it bigger if you like. Make it smaller, make it bigger. Push it back out. Hit home. Again, that is an excellent feature of the EVBASE system here with picture-in-picture and the main screen. To simply go back, all you got to do, go ahead and touch this here. There we go. I'm going to cover how you guys can load some different apps on the system. All that you see here is what EVBASE has set up. However, you can backload an APK file on here. And once again, what I did was I put an APK app on my USB flash drive. I simply just plug it in, let it load real quick. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose File Manager. Oops. Let's go ahead and choose File Manager, Flash Drive, and I have a folder that's called APK. Now, all these apps, they're very easy to find online. You simply just have to download it. And what I wanted to show you guys is just as an example, how to watch Amazon Prime on this screen. So you're just going to click on the APK, the Android system. It's going to do its normal thing. It's going to ask me if I want to install it. I hit yes or install. It's going to go ahead and install. Now that you see app is installed, we're going to go ahead and click done. We're going to get out of here and back to this main screen. Now you see Prime Video is on. So I'm going to go ahead and open it up. It'll probably take a minute or two, if that, to let the application load everything up here. And let's turn this light off so you guys can see. For this part here, I'm going to go ahead and take a quick moment to log into my Prime account. I was able to successfully log into Prime here. We'll turn the light off. You can see that it's fully loading up. And let's see if I can get one of these to play real quick. And there you guys have it. Those are going to be the important aspects of this display that will help you maximize how to use it as best as you can. Now, one thing that I did not cover is the speed play. And I will just tell you guys this right here. Speed Play here is the app that allows you to connect your phone to this display here to use the CarPlay feature. Now, the reason why I did not cover this, I could not get it to work every time. It was very sporadic. So instead of touting it as, hey, this has CarPlay that works good, I didn't even show you guys because you would be somewhat disappointed. I'll share the information with EVBASE. Hopefully they can give a firmware update that's going to make it much more stable, as the connection was on and off, on and off. I did not try the wired side where you can connect your phone over to here, but that might be an option if you want to use the wired feature. So we're just going to click on it. The settings part, you can do a wired connection automatically. I just did the wireless auto connect, which once again was not very stable. But I suggest maybe you guys can try the wired connection itself there. So back to the screen. I do think this is going to be a very worthwhile upgrade. The installation is super easy on the display. You get the air to work. It is a little quirky that you have to have the main HVAC on in order for you to get the fan blowing here. At least you have good control of the heated seats. You have your media controls here. But the biggest selling point for this system, you guys can watch videos back here. You can browse the internet on here. You can just do a lot of different stuff here. And let's go ahead and just try to get out of this here. But YouTube, you can, if you have an Android account, you can set it up in Play Store and just download different things. But I think this is a true game changer for you Tesla owners who have children in the back that want to watch different videos, or they want to browse things here and there. I think this is a great setup. Make sure that you reach out to EVBASE. I will provide a link for you guys to order this here. And then if you have any questions, feel free to post up and I'll do my best to help you guys maximize your return on this rear display here.